Welcome back to Dr. Suchita's interactive class. Now, you might have seen this picture somewhere in detective serials where to find out the victim, they are utilizing fingerprinting. So from fingerprinting, how you can get the DNA of particular victim. This particular analysis is done by using a technique which is called electrophoresis. We'll see today in detail the basic principle of this particular technique, how separation takes place, which are the different types of electrophoresis techniques which are available to carry out the analysis, and the applications of this particular technique. Electrophoresis, so separation is based on applied electrical field. It is mainly the movement of charged particles towards opposite charge electrodes under the influence of electric field. This particular technique was first discovered by a scientist, Arne Tiselius, in 1930, who was awarded for the separation of protein by utilizing this technique, awarded as a Nobel Prize winner in 1948. Further invention in this technique are carried out and developed to check the mobility of ion under electrical field. Zone electrophoresis, gel or disc electrophoresis utilizing agar and starch, and further as a capillary electrophoresis. The main principle involved in separation of the compounds by electrophoresis is carried out according to the size and charge of the particle. Suppose the mixture has been given you, electrical field has been applied, so positively charged species attract to the negative electrode cathode, and negatively charged species attract to the positively charged electrode, that is anode. So under the influence of electrical field, you are separating out charged species by utilizing this technique. The definitely molecular weight or size of the particle affects during the separation, temperature, electrical field strength, and the medium which you are utilizing. Now, when this particular charged species migrate towards cathode and anode, that migration of charged species is defined as migration velocity as mu, whose unit is centimeter per second. So this migration velocity definitely affects with respect to the applied electrical field. So mu is directly proportional to the electric field. If I am increasing electric field, mobility of ion will be faster. If I am decreasing electric field, mobility of ion will be slower. So mobility of ion definitely affects the charged electric field. There are different types of electrophoretic systems as moving boundary electrophoresis, zone electrophoresis, steady state electrophoresis, disc or gel electrophoresis, and Curtin electrophoresis. We see all these particular techniques of electrophoresis by first understanding the instrumentation part of it. The main instrumental components utilized in this particular technique are the mobile phases buffer solution, examples EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic, acid buffer, trisacetate buffer, trisborate EDTA buffer, barbital buffer. Power supply, that is electrical field supply, you need to have over here. Stationary support, which should be inert towards the components which we are going to separate it out. Like use support here is mobile phase buffer solution, and stationary phase is a neutral paper or gel which we are utilizing. Detector. Separated components are detected by using stain, different stain gel. Different inks are utilized to carry out their separations, to detect their separations, like amido black, co-massic blue, Indian ink, silver stain, or you can go for spectroscopic detection such as UV visible detector or mass detector, as depending upon size they separate it out. Moving boundary electrophoresis. This unit is U-shaped, the cross-sectional view I have tried to show over here. Before separation, the instrument will look like this, and after separation, the charged particle move aside from each other. You can see clearly over here. It contains a buffer solution in which electrodes are placed. You need to apply electric field. The sample solution has been placed, which contains mixture of charged species. When I am applying electric field, the charged species will separate out depending upon their mobility, their migration velocity, and charge, as shown in diagram 2. The disadvantages of this particular unit or type of electrophoresis is you can go for a rapidly moving constituent to separate out with very good efficiency or with slow-moving ions. The second type of electrophoresis technique is zone electrophoresis, where when current is passed through the cell, the different constituents of the mixture move with velocity that depend on their electric charge, size and shape. Difference in moving boundary and zone electrophoresis is that the solid support is used over here is filter paper or cellulose acetate. You can see zone electrophoresis further divided into two types of zone electrophoresis depending upon the type of material used, as filter paper zone electrophoresis or cellulose acetate zone electrophoresis. Rest of the part of the system or the principle remains same during separation. Sample is introduced through this stationary solid support as a spot or a band. Electrodes are dipped in a buffer solution in both the cases, and the paper or cellulose is dipped again in the filter paper or buffer solution mobile phase. Now here the question might arise in your mind that here again I am using stationary phase and mobile phase like there in chromatography, but this technique is different from chromatographic technique. Is you are not carrying out separation between by using these two phases, but utilizing these two phases. Separation takes place as inert support of these two phases. In that case, chromatography, they react with the phase in terms of they remains absorbed over the phase, or they carry out partition between the mobile phase. So here, interaction between the buffer or the stationary solid support never ever seen. When I am using filter paper, I can carry out separation of protein, oligosaccharide, carbohydrate, lipids. When I am using cellulose acetate, I can carry out protein separation in biological fluids. The disadvantage of filter paper in zone electrophoresis to be utilized as a stationary force, stationary support, is that it is very thin and tear easily when it is wet. Interaction of biomolecules sometimes takes place with the paper or cellulose which was there in the paper, attracts more amount of water, absorb more affinity towards the water, absorption affinities observed. In case of cellulose acetate, when I am using this as a solid support, it shows some reaction like electroosmotic reaction with cathode and anode fluid. Capillary electrophoresis, name itself tells you that you are putting substance or the solute under separation in a capillary, and that capillary you are passing through the detector system in cathode and anode through buffer solution. So detector and capillary side by side carry out the separation and detects the separated components. This technique is very small, fast, and you carry out the separation by using a very small amount of sample. Steady state electrophoresis, where you are carrying out separation of charged species by doing some variation with the applied electric field. Mobility of fast moving ion carry out at applying very low electric field. If I am increasing electric field, slow moving ions will get separated out. If I am increasing again the electric field, very slow moving ion will separate out, and they will separate by adding specific spacer. We can carry out or separate physically the three charged species from each other depending upon their fast movement, medium and very slow. So this is isostacophoresis, where you are separating out the components by increasing the electric field, whereas isoelectric focusing, where separation of different molecules by their electric field, electric charge difference, you are carrying out the separation. Iso means same charge. You are carrying out separation of protein separation, same charge is there. So protein separation you can carry out by knowing the PI, that is isoelectric point, where net charge on the protein is zero. Protein is amphoteric in nature, having positive and negative charge, zwitterionic and not amphoteric, zwitterionic nature. So if you are having net charge zero, you will become pH equal to PI. So if you know the PI, you can carry out that buffer solution, you utilize and carry out the separation. Here sometimes protein get precipitated out at pH gradient. This is the technique which is known as disc or gel electrophoresis. The unit look like this. This is the container where you can put the gel, upper gel and lower gel. There are two different types of gel we are utilizing. We are separating gel and spacer gel. this is the electric field applied to this particular gel and over which you are putting a buffer solution. After separation, when you put this under UV chamber, you can see the separated protein components like this under UV chamber. If sample is provided from a microbial community where different microorganisms are there, you can carry out DNA extraction of that particular microorganism and you can separate out these mixture of microorganisms, their DNA, based on their DNA by using PCR fragmentation technique. Where denaturation of PCR fragmentation, you carry out, load the sample on gel electrophoresis and based on applied electrical charge, you can carry out separation of these DNA's community to know that they are from different microorganisms. This is the continual continuous electrophoresis where special type of paper has been utilized over here as a stationary phase, buffer being utilized as a mobile phase, and two electrode systems through the buffer solution are attached to this paper. Sample through the reservoir flows in a thin line across this bed in same direction as buffer. When potential is applied across the electrode, the constituents of sample separates in vertical direction as difference in distribution ratio of mobile phase and fixed phase. It can be called as two-dimensional electrochromatography. Here you can isolate and reconcentrate the sample. Wide application of this particular technique under the heading analysis of DNA in forensic labs. Routinely used technique used in forensic investigation, paternity test and code that inherited from the parents, which we can arrange in a sequence that can be analyzed, isolated and cloned. One sequence represents the color of the eye, color of the skin, composition of fingerprinting, determination also we can carry out. Determination and function of protein analysis we have seen in our examples of blood samples where higher and lower levels of protein indicate directly the diseases with respect to biological systems. Antibiotic analysis, synthesis of new antibiotic, very wide application, penicillin determination and vaccine analysis. Recently you need to have a vaccine for COVID, so this might be the technique utilizing influenza. Influenza, this particular vaccine has been analyzed by using this particular technique. This is used in determination of biological fluid constituents, chiral compounds, yes, where you are having same structural arrangement, same structure, mass is same, but structural arrangement vary with respect to their clockwise and anticlockwise direction as RS, R and S configuration. You might have learned this in stereo chemistry, where the molecular arrangement of atoms differs the molecule from each other. Such type of mixture separation is very difficult, which we can carry on by using electrophoresis. Advantages of this technique is excellent degree of purity, application of wide variety of high molecular weight compounds, excellent resolution, rapid separation, simple to operate and easy to construct. Disadvantages, we cannot quantify, or difficulties there in quantifying, and there is a need that large quantity of samples we can analyze using this technique. Hope you have understood in this today's video the basic principle of electrophoresis, type of the technique and wide application in forensics labs. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe.